Red Rose, written by Robert Burns. First, we'll see the introduction of the poet. So, Robert Burns, he was born on 25th January 1759 and hails from Scotland. So, he is a national poet of Scotland. And he writes mainly Scottish dialect. Okay, he has written many satires and narrative, and especially this poem is a ballad. Okay, so it consists of four stanzas. So four stanzas, which has four quatrains, which means it has alternate tetrameter and trimeter lines. That is the each stanza. Okay, the lines of each stanza. That is the first line and third lines have four stressed syllables. And second and fourth stanza has three stressed syllables. Okay. So now we are. First stanza, oh my love, is like a red, red rose that newly sprung in you. Oh my love, is like a memory that sweetly played in you. Second stanza, so fair art than my only lass, so deep in love I am, and I will love thee still, my dear, till the seas gang dry. Stanza 3, till the bees can fly, my dear, and the rocks melt with the sun. I will love thee still, my dear, while the sands of life shall run. Stanza 4. And fare thee well, my love, only love, and fare thee well a while. And I will come again, my love, though it were 10,000 mile. So it is very easy and simplest poem. And the main theme of this poem are love and separation. Okay. So in this, the speaker adores the beauty of her beloved. Okay. So beloved is nothing but the lady love. This lady love. Okay. I'll explain the first stanza. Oh, my love is like a red, red rose. So here the speaker compares his love to a rose. So rose stands. Okay, it stands for the symbol of love. So it is very fresh and young. So likewise, his love seems to be fresh. Okay, second line, that newly sprung in June. Okay, so in the month, we can see the flower, that is the rose, blossom in the month of June. Oh, my love is like a melody that sweetly played in June. Okay, so here he also compares love to the melody of a tune. Okay, so the tune of a song or a music, it can fade away like the rose fades, but this love stands for ever. Okay, the stanza 2, so fair art than my only lass. Okay, here he gives the description of his lady love. The lady love seems to be very fair and beautiful. Okay, so he's very much deep in love with her. So deep in love am I. I will love thee still, my dear, till the sea gets dry. So here he gives assurance. Okay, so he is deep in love with his lady, his beloved. And he also gives assurance that he will love till the sea gets dry. The sea gets dry, it is not possible in reality, but still here the poet uses a hyperbole, which means the exaggeration. Okay, it is actually a metaphor, figure of speech. Okay. And third stanza, still these can dry, my dear, and the rocks melt with the sun. Here is also his love is compared to the sea gadgets. Okay, so that is not possible in reality. So likewise, his love is also compared, okay, and the rocks melt with the sun. So his love will be stable even the nature is destroyed. So it is not possible that rocks melts with the sun. I will love thee still, my dear, while the sands of life shall run. So the time, even though the time passes, his love seems to be very stable and constant. Does it change? Okay, he has true affection. Okay, stanza 4. And fare thee well, my only love, and farewell thee well, a together or 1000 miles together, this love seems to be fresh as well as it is real. Okay, it is a departing is the temporary one. So it seems to be a temporary one. Okay. And farewell thee well, and I will come again, my love, though it were 10,000 miles. Though even he moves 10,000 miles away from her, he comes back with the same love as we saw in the first stanza. Like that, this love seems to be always fresh like a red rose, and even the tone of the music fades away, his love for her never fades away. Okay, and there is many hyperboles mentioned by the speaker. He compares his love to the nature, like the sea ganges dry, the rock melt with the sun, and the sands of life shall never run. Okay, so even all these happens, this love seems to be stable. Okay, there is no changes in his affection. Okay. So I hope you understood the explanation of the poem. This is very simple and easiest poem. Okay, and it is a beautiful love poem, and stones.